Canadian team, Bishop McNamara coming in 10th ranked according to the latest ESPN high school rankings.
Bishop McNamara, obviously, they're big.
They're coming in 10th ranked according to the latest ESPN high school rankings.
Bishop McNamara, obviously, they're big.
25 opponents as we take a look at their starting five, led by McDaniel, the point guard. Nice pass. Harris with a finish down low. Crestwood program into not just national prominence. As there's a look inside. Nice finish. 4-0 start for Bishop McNamara. National prominence. He talked with us about wanting to make a statement that this team belongs amongst the best all across North America, not just in Canada, but competing in a number of American tournaments as well. There's the finish for McDaniel.
Easier said than done.
McDaniel, a Naismith Girls High School Basketball Player of the Year watch list, as there's a finish finally falling for Crestwood Prep. And immediately right back the other direction, Bishop McNamara.
Some easy scores.
Here for Bishop McNamara, Mary Emoting driving and laying it in. McNamara now up 10-3. Here's a steal. McDaniel on the break and one opportunity.
And there you see the speed on defense and with the basketball for Madisen McDaniel there, just reading it really well. It's a really long pass to make, and then the hustle here, and then the strong finish.
Just switched or transferred into Bishop McNamara. Has a number of Division I offers as a junior. Has it picked her college. Swishes it in.
Where they want to go. Get these easy shots.
That one won't fall. McLeod. Transition chance. Samuels up and in. Kick outs. Corner three. Misses everything. Corbett pushing. Nice pass. The lay-in too easy. Samuels with the bucket.
Transition, that's 8 fast break transition points for Bishop McNamara so far.
And there is a basket, a much needed one. Turnovers, as that three is too strong. Bishop McNamara has been able to get out and transition off of defensive boards and just pushing it ahead before this Crestwood team really catches up. There's a lay-in from Fournier.
And there's where
Canadian star with a lot of international experience also helping advance her game. Floater rims in from Kraft. Porter ahead to McLeod. Three ball falls. Got McCure, knocks it down.
Good ball.
Moting able to save it. Corbett with the lay-in.
Yeah, Crestwood's going to have to talk about these defensive assignments. They call it the DMV. You know, tough. Gritty, these kids play ball all the time. They love the game, they love playing, and it shows.
For Bishop McNamara, feed inside. Going to ground there is Kraft. Shot from the elbow, rolls in.
Focus here, again, just the lack of communication on the assignments defensively. Now that can happen sometimes when you're not, you don't have as much time to prepare because you're playing game after game after game.
Working down low, denied, huge block by Fournier. Opportunity in transition. Lay-in goes for McLeod.
From your defense.
Get those high percentage shots out in transition. The drive and the score from Porter.
Here's where I think they have the advantage. When they come down in transition, they need to attack early. Nice little one-legged Dirk Nowitzki.
Exactly, that was a little Dirk
Asia Wilson type move there. Yeah, just nice little one dribble turn, fade away off one leg, just beautiful. She obviously has the ability to jump and dunk, but she has some really good offensive skills that she could be
now
taking.
Just trailing by 5.
There's a combination of the change here with the zone, and even though they're in a zone, they're still aggressive defensively.
For instance, the truth of their team is that they do have depth. Moody coming in off the bench. She's had some big, as there's a turnover, she's had some big performances, 12.6 boards and a ranked win over Duncanville earlier in the season. It was an all-conference honorable mention selection last season. Oh, tough move down low by Corbett.
Yeah, Corbett.
Or McCure, rather. Porter with the ball. McCure for 3, got it!
Crestwood doing a great job. The ball, the opening was not there to get it straight into Fournier initially, and they moved the ball around. And then just a great set shot there, ready to shoot when she catches the basketball.
Education that'll help them moving forward in life, be leaders in whatever they do.
You know, also a little bit of selfish motive there. He himself said he wanted to partake in IHOP.
Movement going to work. McDaniel can't get the lay-in. Pushing the pace here is Crestwood. Corner three falls.
They got the momentum swung now too.
Kick out. Three. And it falls in.
That's it by
not there. Fournier to Porter. Got it! Eva Porter on fire from beyond the arc. 12-2 run. Eva Porter, the junior guard, knocking him down from three.
Yeah, just able in transition to get a wide open look, and Porter is up.
Crestwood now with a chance to extend the lead. They're up by 12 here, midway through quarter number three. Fournier drives and one.
Just a nice isolation on the wing there, defense.
Kind of working the half court offense now. It's Harris. McDaniel gets the bucket and one. Andy McDaniel will go to the line.
Great cut there, and then able to score with contact. She is a strong player. Situation like this, when you're freshman, it's only going to help you grow.
Corbett gives it away. 10 to go. Driving is Fournier, gets the lead. Corner three. Porter thought about it. Amotang out in transition. Nice pass. Graph the finish. It's at 10 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Pacific. Second free throw wouldn't fall. Bishop McNamara trying to close the gap here. Corbett gets one. 2020 grad Aaliyah Edwards led Crestwood. That shot's offline to the 2020 OSBA title. Second one will go with 32.
Really just making sure that they understand the game, the way the Americans play, physical, gritty. But then just, you know, we talked about scouting reports, right? That's something that you really need to make sure for the point to get them ready for the next level.
Another thing that Coach mentioned, there's a quick turnover. Transition chance here for Moody. Lays it in. Turnover, though. Transition chance. Porter denied. Whistle blows. That ball was about heading out to the street.
Yeah, just good hustle getting back. Yeah, just a great timing there. Still want to have good timing.
Fournier working down low. Turn around. Got it.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do about that. Get that much real estate close to the basket. It's a done deal.
Layup falls for Harris.
Here's where you need to see McDaniel take over here. Give them opportunities there. Good look. The right pass.
Lene Corbett with the and one opportunity.
Just great job there getting the defense on her back. And she got her with the lower body there. Fournier.
Turnover though. Pushing is McDaniel.
Here's where she is. Even though she's a little gimpy now, she's gutting it out. She's still going strong downhill.
This game far from over. A minute 30 to go. Three-point ball game. Battle for the ball on the ground. Jump ball.
Working to try to get an opportunity for her team here. Getting the steal and then going downhill. Taking the contact. You know, able to score and then getting back on defense. You got to make the defense move if you're going to drive to the basket.
Harris, up and in. One-point ball game. Loose ball, scramble. Fournier comes up with a big response.
The right place at the right time there. You want to get it to.
Offensive foul to call. Crestwood with the chance. Working in the full court press. Bishop McNamara comes up with it, whistle blows.
Lack of execution on the offensive end.
Misses the second, though. Quick steal for Crestwood. Last few seconds ticking down. Falcolt. A bit tip off just about a half hour from now. There's the final buzzer. Crestwood Prep takes the third place game in the Nike Tournament of Champions 64-58. This was a championship. The Nike Tournament of Champions third place game in the books. Crestwood Prep comes out on top after an absolute battle against Bishop McNamara. On behalf of our entire ESPN crew and my partner,